All right, welcome to another episode from the Chart Reader. So I generally don't do tickers back to back on the same day. The last thing I really want to do is become like a fanboy, right? I'm not here to fall in love with any tickers. I'm just, knock on wood, riding the hot waves up until they come crashing down like they all normally do, right? RGTI has hit a little level of insane, but end of the day, you hear me say it on every single video, volume is king, right? Volume is queen for the ladies watching this thing, right? You know I start up here, I live and die by the lines and the MAs, but volume makes a good thing great or a bad thing worse. And when you just keep growing, 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 today's 300 million shares was the most traded thing in the market. Most stocks that can get that will see good things happening, all right? This is a crazy doji. That was a crazy drop during the day. And what I find the craziest is RGTI went up while QUBT went down, while IONQ went down, while QBTS went down, while what were the other ones? QSI, I think, went down, and then QMCO was the other one. Interesting day in Doji here. But again, I generally believe, and it's why I make these sector videos, right? Sectors should move together. Now, look, I'm always looking for the bullish outlier, right? I want to find the best of the bunch, but they should kind of be moving in the same. And there's some just interesting things happening here. And look, I know it's easy to bite the hype apple, but I'm here doing my best to try to keep the technicals as much of the focus, more than the hype and the all that. All right. So I'm gonna make this a quick one, but I at least wanna cover it again. Just so many requests for it. You know I'm here. I'm not the boss. You all are. I swear, you know that, right? So before we do go any further though, and I give you more of my thoughts and opinions, what are we gonna do? Same thing we always do, right? We'll take a look at the daily and the weekly to see how these things are setting up short term. We'll use our there are five moving averages. I draw horizontal support and resistance lines manually myself. And then when we are done up here, we'll use the MACD, RSI, and volume as our lower indicators. Hey, really quickly, if you can, please subscribe to this channel. Share this video online with your friends. Comment good or bad if you disagree. Look, anything you can do helps so much with these YouTube algorithms. But for real, just being here, giving me your time, oh, I'm so grateful for it. All right. So, couple things that I don't even know where to start here. All right. First and foremost, this is a little bit on the crazy side. All right. I'm gonna start on the last video, on yesterday's video. I actually mentioned I thought there was a real good chance this was gonna come down to about 5:30, 5:40. In so many ways, I was wrong, right? But the morning made it seem like that was gonna be the reality, right? We start. You can see this is the 11th. We're looking at the full day. I mean, the morning tanked, to say the least, right? I mean, it was a rough hour and a half start. Clearly, good things happened afterwards, right? But what went to look like a 540 being right to turn into a positive 13%, that's pretty crazy. The one easy thing to look at is NASDAQ. NASDAQ actually gapped up to an all-time high new candle right here. This has never in the history of ever been at 20,000. That's a big whole round number that it gapped up to, and like, that's some craziness right there, and good craziness. And I kept saying I'm really bullish on NASDAQ. This superseded what I was expecting. But hey, maybe someone can look at RGTI, look at the 13% day, look at the NASDAQ, and kind of say, hey, it makes sense. To me, the biggest thing was the volume. All right. Number one, this has never been this high in the entire, right? Like, the stock did not exist on this day right here. This is the full trading volume history. We've never been at 300 million. This day was the highest. Big day. The question will become, can we sustain this, and can we hold it? Can we keep growing? I am shocked. I really am, that this thing is as high as it was. We've seen it initially go up and come down a lot, right? It went from 270 million all the way as low as 40 million, right? That's almost an 85-ish% drop in volume if I had to do some rough math in my head, right? We've seen the pump and dump. I remember saying, though, it's crazy that we go this high, come this low, price goes here, and then actually kept going up, let alone horizontal, right? So this stock has been next level with volume. It's been next level with the moving averages. I don't know what to think about this doji, and you know I'm always here respecting the dojis, right? What's the word? Give me a second. Oh my gosh, shooting star. There's a couple of things I know how to search for in this crazy little Discord of ours. Seems to be the name. That's the one. Okay. There are people that, look, this one might be a hanging man. Maybe that's what it is. Kind of see the body and the wick right there. Based on this thing, the hanging man kind of says it's going to come down, right? To me, I don't really know the different names of dojis. I'm just here respecting doji things. The one just, I see two different things happening here. This is kind of the last kind of Rigetti specific thought. Rigetti goes away from the 8 and then comes horizontally to the 8, as well as goes to it and then down. It goes to it and then down, goes to it then down. It goes away from it and then horizontal. It's now gone away from it. The question right now is basically going to be, are we going to live horizontally at 7 or are we going to come back down to that same 540 that I mentioned on the last video? Okay. If this can get over, what did you open at? You opened at basically 8. You opened at $7.98. You dropped to, I'll call it 750. If this can break 750, we're going to continue the climb. We're going to continue the climb. The probable place after 750, it looks like that's where we wicked, actually. I think we'll go higher. I think after 750 will probably be 850. I'm not going to draw the line because the next real big line is that 10 right there. I still kind of think we're going to come down to 540. Main little bit less because of this. I'm not much of a candle trader. That's not really what I do. What bothers me, and I said it in the beginning in the opening thoughts, Rigetti went up while some bad things happened in the sector. IONQ, this is what I've been calling a little bit of the strongest one. I love this uptrend and all that. That's the first moment under the 20 right there. That's definitely something to be worth, you know, looking at, and we're below the golden line right there, right? I believe QUBT did an offering. I think that's what happened here. Let me know if I got my tickers wrong, but again, I'm seeing us below the 8. We're getting the not good MACD RSI right there. Again, I can go through the rest of them, right? But when I'm seeing these double digit goes across the rest, there's a little bit of me that worries and still worries. And I hold that same worry from yesterday. Again, if you're going to get the most volume, you're going to fix a lot of issues, right? So the worst thing that can happen is we drop to 100 million shares or less. Right? We've basically lived there most of this uptrend in the last 3 weeks, right? So I would say that's a good normal number for most stocks, right? But that would be a pretty bad two-thirds loss right there, right? So as long as we can stay around that 200-ish million shares, I think good things could still happen. But yeah, I'm a little hesitant. That's all I really can say. Again, I've got my expectations and I'm ready if I'm wrong. And if we break that, what was the number? 750, right? Let's set an alert real quick. Look, an alert's not an immediate buy notification. But yeah, if you get over that, I'm gonna start thinking 8 and then maybe even 10, right? But oh man, I'm not liking the disjointment. The last disjointment I'll talk about, again, you know I love NASDAQ when we're talking about tech stocks, all right? S&P 500 is looking decent. It for sure is. We need one more candle to maybe catch up to NASDAQ. My issue is the Dow Jones. The Dow Jones is actually very disjointed. It's below the 8 and the 20. That's an ugly candle, and that's a pretty ugly red over green and bad volume down there, right? So there's a couple just disjointed things happening, and that really was never the case during the monster uptrends, right? So that's what makes me just think things are a little bit different on the now, okay? Next week is FOMC. I sincerely believe after that call on the 18th, we should get a good idea of what things are going to look like. Hopefully good things happen with the rates. Hopefully Powell does nothing crazy. And then we just ride into the Trump inauguration, and then all the deregulation assumptions that we're assuming he's going to do, and should be really actually good for the market, regardless what you think about him. We're not here to talk about politics, right? So let me know your thoughts. Let me know your opinions. Even if you disagree, let me at least give a couple numbers for the other three. All right, QUBT, look, I think this is the one that gave an offering. Generally, the market doesn't like offerings. Me personally, I don't care. There's nothing on the screen that talks about share count and this and that, right? What needs to happen is we can't lose the 20 moving average. Look, the 20 very often will save the loss from the 8. The 20 is strong enough to bounce you back over the 8 and continue the uptrend, okay? What we really need to do is get over 760. If QUBT can get back over 760, we'll once again test this $8 line. Basically, you can see I'm drawing it at 803. Remember, we've never been anywhere above that $8 line since 2021. And truth be told, it was very early 2021 when it was really good. There was a little peak right there in the summer, right? So don't underestimate that line. But yeah, at the minimum, we need to regain the 8 moving average well before I like it here. I'm actually relatively bullish on this as long as we can stay over $5. That would be a bad fall from 640 down to 5. That's not a pretty one. Hopefully, we never go below 550. I would maybe start considering some alarm bells at 550. There's a chance to lose another 10% below that. We must. Otherwise, green, 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 red, 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 green, green, green will be a bad red, red, red down to 3, okay? Let's look at QBTS really quickly. Look, we gotta regain 50% right here. We gotta get over 455. If we can get over 455, this should be okay. Look, this is still over all the moving averages. This one is actually doing better than the QUBT chart that I just showed, right? Not liking the disjointed MACD and RSI. You want green over red on both, but hey, volume's still there. It actually is, right? So just regain that line. I'll actually set an alert. Yeah, that's not a bad. Again, an alert is not an immediate buy notification. It's a come check it out, right? But we got to get over that. Look, if we lose this 8 moving average, green, 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 red, 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 pretty much nothing. Green, green, green could be a fast fall down to 290. That would be a pretty bad fall. You're losing almost a little bit more than a dollar on a stock that only has 4, right? So I would be really, 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 if 370 is lost, that's where I think some panic might be worth consideration. Again, get me over that 450, 460, whatever your risk tolerance is. All of a sudden, I'm thinking we're going to continue on up and go test that 560 line, all right? And then last on the list is IONQ. I will straight up say I'm surprised we saw these three candles. I actually thought we were going to continue on up, so I for sure got it wrong right here. And more than anything, I didn't think we were going to go below the golden line, let alone the 20 moving average, you know? And again, I was zoomed out for a reason. Once we broke all 5 and flew, all we've been doing is riding the 8, right? This is only a single candle. We're not here to get wildly scared or wildly reactive on a single candle, but there are some requirements, right? And I think it's this. We have to get over $34.50 for IONQ to be viable. Otherwise, if we confirm, look, if we confirm we've lost the 8 and the 20, the next place I actually assume is the 50, right? But I think that this, man, that's really close to the, I'll use this. I think 2660 might be the next support. Obviously, you see my 2355 is the next line down, all right? If we are able to break that $34.50 line that I mentioned, again, over the golden line, good things will happen over that. I actually would assume we would gain about 20% if we can get over that. I for sure got this Monday wrong, let alone the last 3 days. I'm always louder about my mistakes than my victories. I think it sounds cooler when other people say I'm right than when I do, all right? So let me know your thoughts, let me know your opinions, even if you disagree. Oh, I appreciate you all so, so much.